Hi guys, this is Jason here from the Nathaniel School of Music, and in this lesson, let's learn all about octaves, an exciting concept to make your melodies sound a lot more richer and fuller. So let's get started. So the whole goal of this exercise is to teach you how to get from this melody or this style of melody, which is where you play the tune in the right hand and the chord in the left hand, right? Sounds quite pleasant, right? And how you can get from that way of playing the melody to maybe this way. You ask me, that's a lot richer. So if you need that big sound, let's learn how to do it. And if you haven't already, please make it a point to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Turn on that bell icon as well for a lot of notifications and new lessons which will come your way. Let's go. B flat major is the scale I'm going to use for this exercise. B flat major, as we know, has two flats, namely B flat and E flat. The rest are all white keys. And a quick trick when you want to remember something: B flat has two flats. The fact that you have B flat means that there will not be a B, and the fact that you have an E flat means that there will not be an E. So the rest of the natural notes or the white notes are there, and then you add these two black notes or these two flat notes. Okay, so B flat, C, D, E flat, F, G, A, B flat. And let's get our melody. Quite easy, I hope. Okay, and the chords which go with that melody are B flat major, G minor, E flat major. It's a very standard chord progression, right? You have your one chord, B flat, the sixth chord, B flat, G minor, which is the sixth, which is the four, E flat, the 5 or the dominant, which is F. Let's play that again together. B flat, G minor, E flat, F major, G minor. You can even replace the E flat and sneak in the C minor if you wish. Okay, so you can do a lot of things to make this melody a lot more interesting, like do passing notes, grace notes, trills, slurs and whatnot. But in this lesson, let's just focus on the use of octaves. So it's quite easy to just think of it. You just have to play the note which you were anyway playing, which is D, and decide whether you want to go higher or whether you want to go lower. Okay, and each creates an interesting vibe. So you can go, and if you use the sustain pedal, it can sound even more ambient. You get all those overtones sort of coming together to meet in a nice way, isn't it? So with octaves, I'm going to start with a higher octave. I'm just holding the chord in my left hand, not doing anything fancy. But you see how the melody is getting so refined, right? This is pretty much the trick. You just add the octave and you can use these two fingers ideally. I don't think you can use anything else. Your hand will start hurting. So you use the thumb and the pinky as much as possible. And be a bit careful of these middle fingers. You don't want to just hide it too much, or you don't want to keep it jutting out in the air like that. Keep it normal. So if your hand was once here, the octave just stretches the hand slightly, and the other fingers can just be where they were. They don't have to go in a weird motion. Okay, so you're here. So the challenge with octaves is it may sound a bit cut up if you don't use the pedal. So a secret which a lot of piano players do, and it's like an obvious secret because you can't really see their feet. You generally see piano players' hands. The secret is you use this thing called the sustain pedal, which is the right pedal on a like a grand piano alignment. The sustain pedal will basically sustain what you play. Okay? And I'd advise you to watch my tutorial on how to use the sustain pedal. It'll be linked up in the description. Do check that out. It'll just make your melody sound a lot more refined. So if you play... There. This is with the pedal. It sustains. But you have to be careful. You have to lift it here and there. You know? So ideally you want to ensure the legato. That's without... With, of course, with a little bit of lifting. Okay, so that's one way of using octaves. You can either bring up the top note, add a higher pitched melody, or you can do... But of course, then your bass is going to go deeper to accommodate. So I'd advise you when you play deeper... Perhaps you could do like an arpeggio in the left hand, you know, just to add that motion. Some kind of arpeggio motion will always be preferred in the left hand. Okay. And two tips to make the octave sound even more bigger. So first of all, the octaves are very important as piano players. First off, because we can, you know, it's possible to do. It's a lot trickier on other instruments and seemingly impossible on some instruments as well. Like you can't do this on a monophonic instrument, right? Like a flute or a saxophone. It's very... I think it's impossible. So on a piano, you automatically want to capitalize on this octave concept when you play melodies so that it keeps you in the league of all these really sophisticated melodic players like a saxophone or a trumpet or a violin. These are huge instruments. They sound really thick. The piano actually, well, it's a very simple sound if you ask me. The overtones or the harmonics are quite pleasant or quite simple. They don't stand out, you know, like the trumpet or the sax. So one note on a saxophone / violin versus a piano, I think those instruments are going to defeat the piano. So you need to figure out a way to kind of add more density and make the sounds which you already can play a little bit more thicker. And the octaves can definitely help with this. So another way to make the octave sound even more cooler is to sort of do them in a delayed manner. So if you do, sounds quite thicker, but if you create a small delayed effect, what I call as glass octaves, I don't know why, I just like the name. It doesn't have to always be with that delay. You can combine the delay with the no delay, you know. So maybe when the note is long, you could do the delayed octave. Repeat. And you can also fill up the gaps. There are some times where the notes sort of stick, you know. See, there's a lot of gap there. So, as long as you don't confuse the melody, I think it's cool to just add a little bit extra. because you can actually play the notes one by one, you know. So you could either play them with a fast delay or a slow delay. And the slow delay could be timed with your time feel or time division of the song, you know. So I think a lot more interesting, a lot more color than maybe the old version. Or you could use the old simpler version to probably bring down the song at the bridge, or maybe start with the simpler version and then explode with all these techniques. Okay, so the last thing I wanted to mention in this lesson with regards to octaves is how you can also add harmonic octaves or add octaves with thirds. So what you're going to do is play the target melodic note, in this case D, and play its upper third. So what you want to do is write down the B-flat major scale. Theory is very important here. So write down the scale, B-flat, C, D, E-flat, F, G, A. And under each of those notes, you'll find that B-flat's third is D. Okay? 1, 2, 3, warega, and so on and so forth. So B-flat with D, C with E-flat, D with F, E flat with G, F with A, G with B flat, A with C, B flat with D. Now we don't need all these third groupings because our melody doesn't have all the seven notes. But so whenever you encounter the note, now you have D. So D's upper third. This has nothing to do with the left hand. This is only right hand and diatonic to the right hand. So you go. So you add F in between. Remember what we found with our middle fingers, they're pretty much sleeping. Let's bring them, wake them up a bit now. So you go, same thing for the other notes. And if you play that in a flutter or in a delay or in the glass octave way, you know, it sounds even more beautiful. Anything. You can do this for any melody, really. So octaves are great techniques, great tools to add actually in both hands. In today's video, we've talked about the right hand, but I'd love to talk about this more. So if you guys are interested in me teaching you something else or any other topic of music or piano playing or ear training or technology or something which you'd like to learn from us, do leave a comment. And also follow the description for other links which will help you out with other chapters. So that brings me to the final point. Do subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Turn on the bell icon for notifications and you'll get a lot more videos from me and other performances as well, which you should look out for. And do support our channel as well by sharing the video with all your musician friends. So in this lesson, we've learned about octaves. First of all, it's just an additional note, the same pitch into two as we learn in physics class. You either play the higher octave or the lower octave. Then what do? Then you can add some flutter or some excitement by creating more density, by adding more of the subdivisions. Then what did we do? We added the thirds. We added the upper third from every note. Need to write it down neatly in the book. Get your theory sorted. And there we go. We've learned it on B flat major with just a simple melody which I came up with. But I hope that you can apply it to some of your own compositions or maybe some songs which you're trying to figure out on your own. And I'd love to hear what you've come up with. Again, this is Jason here from Nathaniel School of Music. Cheers, have a good one, stay safe, and I will catch you soon.